Everyone, I'm Mark Clay.
I'm Krista DuBille. More than 100 students at the African-Centered College Preparatory Academy were not allowed to attend school today because they didn't follow the dress code.
Now, this comes just one day after the district expelled 50 students for ongoing behavioral problems. Sayed Shabir spoke to parents, students, and the superintendent and explains why a change in enforcement has been made.
I showed up for school.
10th grader Poshae Jackson's Tuesday morning at school was cut short before it even started when she and her 650 schoolmates showed up at the African-Centered College Preparatory Academy. They were greeted with a dress code inspection. More than 100 failed and were sent home, including Jackson, who had an orange logo on the heel of her shoe.
Normally we could wear all these shoes, but now since the district up here, now they want to take it all serious, like we can't wear this and we can't wear that.
District officials were at the high school all morning. So were security guards who forced those not in dress code to wait outside.
We out here cold. Where everybody got a jacket, I ain't got nothing. Because they want to tell me yesterday I couldn't wear no sweater. So now I come to school without a sweater. Now they want to trip about my shoes.
The sudden strict enforcement surprised parents.
When school started, they should have said they need to wear black shoes. They should have had everything straight, and now that these kids are wearing different color shoes or this and that, now they want to send them home. And now parents got to come up here every day.
Her kids were sent home for the day, but a day earlier, 50 kids were sent home permanently.
Some of those students had some pretty extensive records of ongoing confrontation with teachers, ongoing fights or initiating fights, being in fights, and so those made the list.
Dr. Green and his staff plan on working from the high school for as long as it takes to see an improvement. Sayed Shabir, 41 Action News.
The African-Centered College Preparatory Academy plans on holding a meeting tomorrow night. It will be at 6 o'clock in the evening in the main auditorium of the high school. School employees will talk about the zero tolerance policy for code of conduct, as well as today's uniform violations.